So just to continue our conversation, how do you think that agency models will have to change to take advantage or to stay one step ahead of the digital scene in the region?
I think it's the same issues that we're seeing across the world. I think that, you know, agencies are going to have to reinvent their role to be able to continue to add value within the mix. I think that we're seeing a lot of the sort of traditional barriers to entry crumbling, which forces agencies to reconsider, you know, their role in the value proposition, and of course not to rest on their laurels. They have to continue to shift the dynamism of all these changes that are coming across us. I think, you know, one key element is the economies of scale are starting to reduce. So I talk obviously from a media agency perspective, and we talked about this certainly in the past, that, you know, there's a clear barrier to entry that exists. And that is that sheer volume and clout enables an agency to corner a market. Now, a lot of the new sort of advertising models and marketing techniques out there have done away with that process entirely. There is no media trading involved. I use the example of social media. PPC works very much in this space, and we're seeing that sort of model starting to proliferate, you know, across a number of other options. So that's a key area, you know, for us to then think, okay, clout and commoditization has always been a big issue for any agency. So I think it's important to say that with that crumbling, we have to reinvent our roles. And one such area that we're obviously very keen to reposition is in a more consulting role. You know, we come to the table without producing in particular too much of a product other than what's up here. And that's always been the core of our job. But over time, we sort of leaned on, you know, certain, let's say. Now, I think that's a big change. I think that's something that's going to happen. Another area that I see a lot of changes is, you know, we traditionally came from a background of a full-service agency. And that happened in a day when the media and the advertising sort of industry was far simpler. And so having a full-service service structure essentially was possible. Then we saw, you know, the emergence of specialists who came in. And as the technologies continue to sort of evolve, more specialists, you know, required. So consequently, what happened is it forced a brand marketer to have to engage a number of agency relationships on multiple levels to be able to activate a single campaign, let's say. And that has arisen a number of frustrations on their side, having to play the role of coordinator, dealing with agency conflicts, the whole thing. So now we're starting to see that reversal of the model. Specialists are still needed. They are required. But we're now starting to see that you can house those specialists within, you know, the same teams. And they can work as sort of cross-multifunctional experts surrounding brands or problems or issues or products or whatever it is, and working together to sort of derive a common goal. And that's interesting because that kind of has borrowed a lot from the design industries and how they're working. Some of the real innovators in design had already, I think, jumped on this a few years ago. And we're seeing that now starting to come into our industry as well.
And would you say that players in the region have the skills to be able to do this?
Not yet.
Or is there still going to be another...
Sorry, I'm jumping in, all right. No, I think that there's a lot of learning to be done. Yeah. I do believe, though, that that's the future. I think that, you know, we've seen... And there will always be a role for the specialist, don't get me wrong. But I think an agency that wants to... rise upstream in the client relationship, in the priority, in the relationship with your advertisers, is going to need to be one that can provide at least the core of a full service strategy. And another point I think to just sort of add on to that is that the digital space is one where the synergies that exist between traditionally disparate service agencies is really blurring the lines. So, you know, I think gone are the days where you can categorize agencies by type. You're going to see agencies that will evolve with a traditional core competency, but having to create you know, all these, or bringing in all these new skill sets in-house?
So internet is obviously the great equalizer. I mean, I can sit at my desk here and see a campaign that's going on in the States or in Japan. Do you think that the brands now have to look at global campaigns, or is there still space for very much the local angle?
I think so. There have been some fantastic examples of salient approaches that seem to resonate globally, which I think is a fantastic example of the fact that globalization is happening. You know, that the sort of cultural barriers are breaking down, and you know, people will get it in this country and they'll get it in that country. But overridingly, you do need that local knowledge and to understand which buttons you need to press, to have a core understanding as to which are the insights that will enable you to be successful within a given market, the kind of messages you need to be pushing, the behaviors you wish to sort of capitalize upon. That still happens on a local level. So yes, we have seen the emergence of global sort of campaigns, but by far and away they have been global initiatives with local sort of relevance and sort of execution.
And final question, rumors have been going on for some time now that the print media is very much on the way down in terms of advertising, TV's on the up, internet's on the up. When do you really see digital coming into its own in the region? For every year we kind of hear this is the year of digital, this is the year of digital. When do you foresee that actually happening?
Well, you're right to say that digital is going to grow at the expense of print. That's what's happening today. We still see TV growing. We even still see cinema growing. We see outdoor has been hit hard temporarily. That'll probably bounce back and maybe reinvent itself. Print is the big casualty of this mix and is perhaps the first to fall, maybe not the last one. When will that happen here? I think it is happening here. The cannibalizing is happening. The growth is at the expense of what used to be a very strong print sector. And I think the emergence, the introduction of these new mobile devices like the iPad are the first step in, I think, the sort of putting the nails in the coffin, so to speak. Print has always fallen back on its, you know, sort of tangibility, its, you know, portability. And I think that these new technologies coming into play enhance that and give it a whole new lease of life. So I if I want to go out there, I'll say that it's happening today. Stick my neck out. I think it's happening today. The last 12 months has seen an enormous growth in digital in the region. Probably more growth in the last 12 months than the previous 5 years, to put it into perspective. The recession came here. It didn't affect the growth by any means. It probably, just the opposite, actually acted as a catalyst to continue the growth and at a more rapid pace. And I would say that the next 12 months, 24 months, we'll continue to see this growing dramatically. And we're starting to see the tipping point. You talked earlier about how many internet users there are, and the next 3 years shows a very positive outlook.
Dimitri, thank you very much.
Thank you, Ed.